Hello, this is Swami Narasimhananda from India. I'm very happy to participate in this conference on hypnosis on the panel on consciousness. I'll be sharing my ideas on consciousness according to Advaita Vedanta, which is a system of philosophy in the Indian tradition, forms part of Hinduism. Consciousness, according to Advaita Vedanta, which believes in a non-dual reality, a reality where there are no two ultimate realities, there is only one without a second, and that reality is the ultimate reality, and this consciousness is the only thing which truly exists. It's not a thing. It's beyond names and forms. It's beyond time. It is beyond space. And it is beyond causation. And it is the ultimate reality. And consciousness from this perspective is not something which is objective. It is not something which one has. But it is subjective. It is the nature of a person. So, you don't have consciousness. You are consciousness. You don't have consciousness. You are consciousness. And so, in Sanskrit, the true reality, which is not understood by us, and the goal of spiritual life is to understand this reality. That reality in Sanskrit is called Sat, absolute existence, Chit, absolute consciousness, and Ananda, absolute bliss. So that is the reality which we need to understand. And so that, by understanding that reality, it is again not an objective knowledge, but a subjective knowledge. And by understanding that reality, we would be, in a sense, understanding ourselves. So by understanding that we are something beyond this body, mind, names, forms, space, time, causation, beyond this universe, and by understanding that, we will understand that we are not in this universe which creates suffering. This is the general idea of consciousness. So from this perspective, consciousness becomes entirely a subjective element. In fact, it's not an element, it is something that you are. So, to think about consciousness as the other, as something which has to be thought about, goes against this worldview. Consciousness is not something to be thought about. It is something because of which you think. It is something based on which you think. And consciousness is your entire being. Consciousness is what you are. Not in the sense that I am talking and I am working, etc. That is a wrong reading of consciousness. So consciousness as understood in the common sense parlance, where you talk, where you think, you write, and you interact with people, you have a conscious mind, etc., so on and so forth, that is against your true nature, where you are beyond actions, beyond thoughts, beyond speech, beyond mind, etc. So this is a very difficult kind of situation, because we are thinking with our mind. So to grasp something which is beyond the mind, beyond thought, is impossible through the mind. And that is why the scriptures, Hindu scriptures say that consciousness is something which is beyond words, beyond thought, beyond speech, beyond time, and it is beyond all ideas of this universe which we have. So, to reach to that kind of a state, you have to basically transcend your mind. So, you have to go to a state of mind where the mind does not exist. That is called nirvikalpa. That means there is no alternative. Vikalpa also means thought. So, a thoughtless state. And samadhi, that means where you become one with yourself. You become one with your true nature or your true basis. Now, consciousness seen from this perspective is the final truth. It is the final truth. And that is the only truth. It is not something which we understand through our mind and the sense organs, but it is something which we understand beyond our mind and sense organs. So, it is not a perception or an experience which comes through a medium, but it is a perception or experience which comes beyond any medium. So, it is called an immediate perception. The word in Sanskrit is aparoksha anubhuti. Anubhuti means perception or experience. And aparoksha means that which is beyond any medium of sense organs or mind. And because that is the only truth, there is no dichotomy in Advaita Vedanta between matter and consciousness, which again comes as a big shock, big blow. How can there be no dichotomy between matter and consciousness? But there is no dichotomy. So, matter, what we see matter in our day-to-day lives, what we see matter as matter, what we consider matter in our day-to-day lives, is essentially conscious. And what we consider conscious in our day-to-day lives is also essentially conscious. Because in this whole world, there is nothing but consciousness. So then why do we consider something as matter? And why do we consider something as conscious? Because the very fact that we are seeing this universe, that we are perceiving that some things are matter and some things are conscious, is because of our causal or primal or fundamental ignorance regarding the true reality, that is, everything is conscious. Or only consciousness is. Not everything is conscious, but only consciousness is. And because of that ignorance, which we don't know when it started, we don't know the beginning of that ignorance, this consciousness has been wrongly perceived as having names and forms. And wherever we see more ignorance or less of consciousness, that we consider matter. And wherever we see less ignorance and more of consciousness, we consider conscious. But in reality, there are no names, no forms, no space, time, causation, but only consciousness, which has got no other boundaries. There are no boundaries in space. There are no boundaries in time. There are no boundaries in causation. Means this conscious principle has no cause. It is the cause of everything else. Because based on this, you consider other things, or you consider things to be there. Based on this, you consider that there is this universe. So, this is the whole idea. And then again, the concepts of good and evil also come because of ignorance about the true nature. There is nothing called good or evil from the absolute perspective, but we do see good, we do see evil, we do see suffering because of our ignorance. So when you see good also, that is also because of ignorance. When you see evil also, that is also because of ignorance. But as long as you see good, as long as you see evil, there is ignorance. And as long as you see them, you have to transact with them, you have to tackle them. And so, the only way to do that is to understand that the reality is beyond good and evil, is beyond virtue and vice. And when I look at, say, dead wood, when I say look at a book, or when I say look at a piece of equipment or machinery, I need to understand that I am seeing myself as different from this book or this piece of machinery. I am seeing myself as different from another person because I have this fundamental ignorance regarding the ultimate reality. If I knew that reality, then I would not see myself and the other person. In fact, I would not see anything as we see now. Why? Because then this whole world of differences would cease to remain. I would not see this world of differences. I would rather only perceive or experience that non-dual truth. In fact, there will be no I. So, I would not perceive anything as I perceive now. In the example given by Sri Ramakrishna, who was a great mystic, lived from 1836 to 1886 in India, he says that if a salt doll, a doll made out of salt, ventures on the task to measure the depth of the ocean and goes inside the ocean, what would happen? The salt doll obviously would get dissolved in the ocean and cannot measure the depth of the ocean. So when we try to understand the true reality, which is also called Brahman, we become one with it. And there is no we and that reality. There is no separate individuality. So the individuality merges into the absolute. So consciousness is something which is the basis. And giving the classical analogy of Advaita Vedanta, we say, there is a dark room with no light, and there is a coiled rope kept there. A person gets into that room and stumbles on the rope, coiled rope, and mistakes it to be a snake which is seated there in a coiled form, and starts sweating, perspiring, heart starts palpitating, etc., and tries to get some stick to drive away that snake, or tries to find some things like the carbolic acid or something to drive away the snake. But somebody comes and, or that person itself, the person oneself puts a light. Puts a light and sees that it is not snake. It is a coiled rope. So that is the analogy. So this whole world is like that dark room. This universe is like that dark room. And the truth is like this coiled rope. which we mistake to be snake. So we mistake this truth to be this universe names and forms, whereas this truth is nothing but rope. So this is a delusion where we mistake the rope to be snake. And we get suffering in the form of perspiring, sweating, etc. So consciousness is that rope based on which we have the idea of this universe. Where there were no rope, we would not have this wrong idea of snake. This is the general idea of consciousness as the substratum, as the basis of everything. Everything, including this universe. Thank you, and I am happy that I got an opportunity to share my thoughts in this prestigious conference. Thank you. Namaste.